At the start of this service of praise and worship, we welcome all of you to Canterbury Cathedral for Evensong, and I do so on behalf of the chapter and the community who meet here. Today the church remembers the life and witness of Anne and Joachim, the parents of the Blessed Virgin Mary, as we remember how God has been at work in our midst for generations leading up to the coming of the Christ. Tonight, our service is again sung by our visiting choir who are with us this week from George's Episcopal Church in Nashville.
We sit for Psalm 119, verses 145 to 152, which can be found on page 510 of the small red prayer books. We stand for the Gloria at the end of verse 152.
The 11th chapter of the first book of Samuel. And the people have asked Samuel to give them a king. And at the same time as this, they are being attacked by Nahash, king of the Ammonites. About a month later, Nahash the Ammonite went up and besieged Jabesh-Gilead. And all the men of Jabesh said to Nahash, "Make a treaty with us, and we will serve you." But Nahash the Ammonite said to them, "On this condition I will make a treaty with you, namely that I gouge out everyone's right eye, and thus put disgrace upon all Israel." The elders of Jabesh said to him, "Give us 7 days' respite, that we may send messengers through all the territory of Israel. Then, if there is no one to save us, we will give ourselves up to you." When the messengers came to Gibeah of Saul, they reported the matter in the hearing of the people, and all the people wept aloud. Now Saul was coming from the field behind the oxen, and Saul said, "What is the matter with the people that they are weeping?" So they told him the message from the inhabitants of Jabesh. And the Spirit of God came upon Saul in power when he heard these words, and his anger was greatly kindled. He took a yoke of oxen and cut them in pieces and sent them throughout all the territory of Israel by messengers, saying, "Whoever does not come out after Saul and Samuel, so shall it be done to his oxen." Then the dread of the Lord fell upon the people, and they came out as one. When he mustered them at Bezek, those from Israel were 300,000, and those from Judah 70,000. They said to the messengers who had come, "Thus shall you say to the inhabitants of Jabesh-Gilead, 'Tomorrow, by the time the sun is hot, you shall have deliverance.'" When the messengers came and told the inhabitants of Jabesh, they rejoiced. So the inhabitants of Jabesh said, "Tomorrow we will give ourselves up to you, and you may do to us whatever seems good to you." The next day, Saul put the people in three companies. At the morning watch, they came into the camp and cut down the Ammonites until the heat of the day. And those who survived were scattered, so that no two of them were left together. The people said to Samuel, "Who is it that said, 'Shall Saul reign over us? Give them to us that we may put them to death.'" But Saul said, "No one shall be put to death this day, for today the Lord has brought deliverance to Israel." Samuel said to the people, "Come, let us go to Gilgal, and there renew the kingship." So all the people went to Gilgal, and there they made Saul king before the Lord in Gilgal. There they sacrificed offerings of well-being before the Lord, and there Saul and all the Israelites rejoiced greatly. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you.
22nd chapter of the Gospel according to Luke, beginning to read from the 39th verse. We find ourselves in that part of the story leading up to the crucifixion of Jesus. He came out and went, as was his custom, to the Mount of Olives. And the disciples followed him. When he reached the place, he said to them, "Pray that you may not come into the time of trial." Then he withdrew from them about a stone's throw, knelt down and prayed, "Father, if you are willing, remove this cup from me. Yet not my will, but yours be done." Then an angel from heaven appeared to him and gave him strength. In his anguish, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat became like great drops of blood falling down on the ground. When he got up from prayer, he came to the disciples and found them sleeping because of grief. And he said to them, "Why are you sleeping? Get up and pray that you may not come into the time of trial." Here ends the second reading.
Thank you.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sins, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Oh.
This evening's anthem is a setting of the Jubilate Deo, Psalm 100 by Herbert Howells. Let us pray. Lord, we pray for your church, praying for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, and today for the Diocese of Waiapu in the Anglican Church of Aotearoa, New Zealand and Polynesia. We pray for Rose, Bishop of Dover, and for the Diocese of Canterbury, praying for the sixth benefice, and for the clergy, Julian Staniforth, Amanda Lane, and Nick Carpenter. We give thanks for the beauty of our worship here in Canterbury, and for our visiting choirs, and pray today for St. George's Episcopal Church, Nashville. Heavenly Father, by whose grace the whole of humanity is called to praise you, bless the worship of this place. Be with us in all our singing and our speaking, and in the meditations of our hearts. that as we adore you in the beauty of holiness, so our lives may be transformed by your Spirit to reflect the pattern of that life of self-giving love known to us in your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Lord, we pray for your world. Today, as we remember Saints Anne and Joachim, parents of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we give thanks for the gift of love and for our families. We pray that our families may be places where we learn more about you and your love for us. We pray for families throughout the world, and especially for those struggling as a result of violence, oppression, war, poverty, and natural disaster. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks that you look on creation with the eyes of love, and that you have fashioned human beings so that we can respond with that same love to one another and to you. In your mercy, help us to become more loving like Anne and Joachim, deepen our delight in our relationships of love, and make us more generous in sharing our love, that those who feel alone and unwanted may find in our care a glimpse of your endless love for them. In Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We conclude our prayers by joining together in the words of the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, evermore. Amen. As you leave today, our stewards will be holding baskets to receive your cash donations, and there is also an electronic donation point for bank cards near the door as you leave. We ask you to be generous in your donation, as our music, mission, and care of our cathedral costs nearly £30,000 per day. We thank you for your support. We stand to sing our hymn from the Ancient and Modern Hymn Books, number 314.